Hello, Patrick Walchuk here with an update on the Ottawa real estate market. We're with the Agent in Ottawa team here at REMAX Hallmark. Now, before I get into the statistics for Ottawa and the surrounding areas, just a couple of points about this unique market that we're in. Now, buyers are very frustrated, admittedly, right now. One-third of all homes sold in Ottawa in the month of April 2019 sold above list price. You've probably heard the term bidding wars, where you have two or more offers on a property. It jacks up the price and it sells for over list price. So one-third of homes did sell for over list price. Lots of bidding wars. Half of the sales in Ottawa sold for below list price. So although it seems that every deal is happening with a bidding war, that's not the case. Now, the properties that are in certain neighborhoods that are priced properly will have multiple offers. For example, there was a property that I showed to a couple of different clients I have in Elmvale Acres, listed for $400,000, and it needed a lot of work. And based on a couple of other places I'd been in that recently sold, I told my clients, well, geez, you know, this is going to bidding wars, I'm sure of it. And I think it could go over list price, not 400, but 425, maybe 430. And it sold for $472,500. I don't know how many offers they had, but I believe it was around 15 or more. So sometimes these bidding wars are really crazy. And I've had a couple of buyers in the past week that have bowed out of even looking for a house right now. They say it's too much of a seller's market, and who could blame them? So if you are going to be a buyer and you are going to look at a property and maybe find one of those 50% that sell for below, the most important thing that you can do is to get yourself pre-approved for a mortgage. Now, all that being said, let's look at the statistics. So for the month of April, for residential properties, that's anything other than a freehold, the sales were about flat with last year. They were down 1%. There were 1,594 homes sold, and prices for residential property were almost $489,000, and that's an increase of 7.4%. For condominiums, there were 438 of them sell, and that was an increase of 5.3%. And in terms of the prices, the average condo price in Ottawa now is $307,659, and that's an increase of 14% over April of last year. In terms of how long it's taking for a property to sell, residential homes are selling in 44 days compared to 47 last year. Condominiums are selling in 52 compared to 58 last year. And talking about the frustration as we started this video, it's because the inventory levels remain very low. Residential inventory levels are down 18% compared to April of last year. There's currently about 2,900 homes for sale in Ottawa. That's it, all of Ottawa. And condominiums, get this, inventory levels are down almost 40%. That's 40. And there's only 794 condos for sale. That's less than a 3-month supply. And multi-unit properties, if you're looking to buy a 2, 3, or 4 unit building, their inventory levels are down 40%. There's only 78 of these buildings for sale in all of Ottawa. So let's look at the three major suburban areas, and we'll start with Orleans to our east, obviously. Now, in April, there were 235 sales in Orleans, and that's a decrease of almost 10% over April of last year. Of that, 194 of those homes were freehold homes, non-condominiums, and that's a decrease of 7.2%. There were 41 condos sell, and that's down almost 20%. And again, a lot of this is just related to a lack of inventory, a lack of product for people to buy. The average price in Orleans was $407,000, and that's an increase of about 5%. Now, I'll just quote you a couple of different housing types that have sold in Orleans. So the average price of a residential townhome and a semi was $371,000. That's an increase of about 7.7%. And the average price of a condo townhome and semi was $253,000, which is an increase of 8.4%. Now, I won't go on with this because you can go to our blog where we break out even more types of housing, the number of units sold, the average prices. There's a lot of great information on our blog about sales in Orleans. So let's move on to Barrhaven. In Barrhaven, month of April, there were 171 homes sell, which is a decrease of 8% compared to April of last year. Of those sales, 146 were freehold properties, anything other than a condo, and that's a decrease of 11%, and there were 25 condo sales, up 13%. Now, the average price for all types of homes sold in Barrhaven in April was closing in on $447,000, and that's down 11.7% compared to April of last year. Again, just a couple of different statistics on the types of homes that sold. So for residential, townhomes, and semis, the average sold price was $399,000, which is an increase of 10%. And if we look at the sales of condo townhomes and semis, $244,833, and that's an increase of 3.4%. And again, if you go to our blog, we've got lots of great information about Barrhaven and sales for not just April, but historically as well. So Barrhaven's doing extremely well. Now, moving on to the other area that's also doing extremely well is Kanata. So in Kanata in April, there were 214 homes that traded hands, and that's an increase of almost 6% over April of last year. Now, of those 214, 198 were freehold homes, 198 freehold homes, and that's an increase of 14.5%. 16 condos traded hands, and that's a decline of about 45%. And again, part of the reason there is lack of inventory. Now, the average price of a home that's sold in Kanata is $474,000, and that's an increase of 10%. Pretty common with all the other areas. We're seeing a lack of inventory, and prices are going up, and there's a lot of multi-offers or bidding wars on homes all throughout Kanata. Now, I'll give you a couple of different housing types and average prices. So, for example, residential townhomes and semi-detached, the average sold price was almost $413,000, which is an increase of 8.7% over April of 2018. When we look at the same type of house, but as a condo, so condo townhomes and semis, the average sold is approximately $231,000, and that's an increase of 2.2% over last year. And again, go to our blog for Kanata, and we have not only that information, but a whole lot more information breaking out the different types of housing, the average sale prices, the number of sales, all that good stuff. Any questions, don't hesitate to give us a call.